Hello everyone, welcome back to English classes. Today we are going to start chapter number 6 from the book Honeycomb. The name of the chapter is Expert Detective. So let's talk about the chapter. This lesson is a story of two young detectives who were inquisitive about a man who was polite, a recluse with health problems. Michal's mother, a doctor by profession, knew the man as a patient. They persistently searched for evidence against him. However, these were more imaginary than incriminating. Their dedication, curiosity is obvious in their acts, and the narrator recounts the early childhood days of her. So in this story, you are going to meet these characters. First one is narrator, the girl, and the name of the girl is Maya, and she is 10 years old. And yes, her brother named Nishad. So Nishad, a boy of 7 years old, also called 7 because his name means the 7th note on the musical scale. So one boy, two names, Nishad and 7. Doctor mother of them, Mr. Nath, the patient, Ramesh, okay, and a stranger. So all these characters you are going to meet in the story. And yes, the two young detectives are Nishad and her sister Maya. Then one day the children, what happened, they both were very curious about one person, that is Mr. Nath. And one day the children's marble rolls into Mr. Nath's room. Here it is, the introduction is given of the chapter. Nishad, a boy of 7, and his 10-year-old sister Maya are very curious about one Mr. Nath. Then one day the children's mother rolled into Mr. Nath's room, and Nishad gets a chance to see him. Is he a crook on the run? So dear student, they are they want to know about Mr. Nath. Okay, so what they want to know, that is he a crook on the run? Why is his fate badly scarred, and why he has no friends? Nishad's mother, a doctor, knows Mr. Nath as a patient. So their mother is a doctor and Mr. Nath is a patient of their mother, and who is very polite. Who is polite? Mr. Nath. So let's read about the chapter. If I open the page number 85, Expert Detective Part 1. As we, so here we, narrator and her brother. As we walked back towards the cleaning 7th set, he doesn't look anything like a monster, Maya. But did you see how thin he is? Maybe he is very poor and can't afford to eat. Dear students, listen carefully. In this chapter, rather than story, okay, conversation will be there. Okay, so conversation part between the between Maya and Nishad will be there. So in this form, you will get the story. As we have told in the, as I have told you in the introduction, that Nishad, marble roll into the Mr. Nath's room, and they went there, okay, and they just took back the marble. And after coming back from the cleaning, what were they discussing? As we walked back towards the cleaning 7th set, he doesn't look anything like a monster, Maya. Means his appearance was just like the monster. But did you see how thin he is? But had they noticed about his body structure that he was very thin? Maybe he is very poor and can't afford to eat. Now he is answering, like, might be he was not having very much money, he was very poor, so he couldn't afford to eat. He can't be poor if he is a crook on the run, I told him. Then Maya told Nishad, her brother, that he couldn't be poor if he was a crook on the run. If he was criminal who run away from some place, then he should have some money. He's probably got millions of rupees stashed away somewhere in that room. So stashed away means hidden away. So the person who is writing the story, Maya, is saying, Maya told her brother, he was probably got millions of rupees, crores of rupees stashed hidden away somewhere in that room. Do you really think he's a criminal, Maya? He doesn't look like one. Nishad looked doubtful. Now Nishad was very doubtful about his structure, Mr. Nath's structure. So he looked doubtful and asked Maya, did she really think he was a criminal? Because he didn't look like one. By appearance, he didn't look like a criminal. Of course, he is 1'7", I said. And he certainly isn't starving. Mr. Mehta told us that Ramesh brings his meal up from the restaurant downstairs. So, Maya replied to Nishad that of course he is 1'7". Of course, he was a criminal. And he certainly isn't starving. And obviously, indeed, he was not starving because Mr. Mehta told them that Ramesh brought his meal up and from the restaurant downstairs. From the restaurant, Ramesh brought meal and gave to Mr. Nath. So you can see he's Nishant, Maya, and they both were talking about Mr. Nath. So open next page number 86. But Maya, Mr. Mehta told us he doesn't work anywhere. So how can he possibly have money to pay for food? Nishad said. Now Nishad was again asking that Mr. Mehta told them that Mr. Nath, he didn't work anywhere. So how it was possible that he could have some money to pay for his food? Exactly, I exclaimed. Then Maya was she was also very exclaimed, and she told, exactly, it was my point. He must have lots of money hidden somewhere. He was not earning something, so must he have some money in his room, and maybe in that trunk in his room. They have seen a trunk in Mr. Nath's room, so they were thinking and they were guessing that he might hidden some money in that in that trunk. It's probably full of silver and gold and jewels and dash. So what they are expecting, that they were thinking like might be, it was the possibility that trunk was full of silver and gold and jewels and dash means. Nishad interrupted. Nishad stopped Maya between his talk, between her words, and said, what rubbish you are saying, rubbish things. I know I am right, stupid, I told him. Maya told Nishad, yes, I know. She knew that she was saying right. By the way, Seven, did you see his cars? I couldn't. It was too dark, but I bet he caught them during a shootout with the police or something. So, dear student, here Maya is explaining about the appearance of Mr. Nath, and she told, she asked from her brother Seven, had he seen what? The scars, marks, okay, bad marks, ugly marks on the face of Mr. Nath. I couldn't, it was too dark. Okay, so it was too dark that they were not able to see clearly, but I bet he caught them during a shootout with the police or something. Now she was very sure, and surely she was saying, I can bet for that he got these marks during the shootout or during the fought between him and police. Mummy told us quite clearly they were burn scars, Nishad said firmly. But Nishad told very firmly, very strongly, that their mother told them that this would be these marks, those marks were burn marks. Burn marks means, yes, they were burned from fire. Now, perhaps the police had to set his house on fire to force him out, I suggested. Sam looked unsure. Now, again, Maya replied to Nishad's question, Nishad's view, like Nishad was saying that their mother told them about the marks, like it was just burn marks only. So again, Maya suggesting, and she was very sure the police had to set his house on fire to force him out, that and during that time he got that burn marks. On the Monday following Mama's birthday, Seven went alone with her to the clinic at Gidcombe, as I was spending the evening with a school friend. When they returned, Nishad told me he had been to see Mr. Nath, and I felt most annoyed that I hadn't been there. So now it is a time, they are talking about Monday, Mama's birthday. So Mama's birthday was there, so Seven went alone. 7, went alone with her to the clinic and came home as I was spent the evening. So Maya was busy with her friend at home. They were spending their evening together at home, and Seven went to the clinic with her, with his mom. And when he returned back with his mom, then Nishad and his mother came back from the clinic. Then Nishad told Maya about, like, he had seen Mr. Nath, and yes, they, and after listening that Nishad met Mr. Nath, Maya felt very bad because he was not able to see Veer. Seven had been quite upset about Mr. Nath's gaunt appearance and was sure that he was starving. He told me that he had knocked loudly on Mr. Nath's door that evening and said, "Open the door quickly, Mr. Nath." So what happened? Seven went there, where? Mr. Nath's room. So Seven had been quite upset. He was very sad about Mr. Nath's appearance, Mr. Nath's weakly appearance, because he was very weak, very sick. Sick-look person. Okay, so he was very thin person. So Seven was very upset and very sad about his appearance and was sure that he was starving, because, and starving means lacking of food. Okay, so the Mr. Nath was like was not having enough food. So the person Seven was feeling very bad for him. He told me that he had knocked loudly on Mr. Nath's door. Now Nishad told his meeting with Mr. Nath to Maya, and he told that he went there, he just knocked loudly on the door, and yes, opened, and he was saying, "Open the door quickly, Mr. Nath," and he was requesting Mr. Nath to open the door quickly. The man had opened it and asked him, "Lost another marble?" It means that man recognized Seven. When Nishad went there, he was knocking at the door, the man opened the door and he asked the question, "Lost another marble?" Means you have lost your another marble, that's why you are here. He had obviously recognized my brother. Then Maya thinks, yes, he recognized, he identified my brother. "No," said Nishad. "He had taken the man's hand in his own and thrust a bar of chocolate into it." Then what happened? As he opened the door and asked, "Lost another marble?" Nishad replied, "No." And suddenly what happened? He just took man's hand and kept a bar of chocolate into his hand. "Did you get a chance to peek into the trunk, Seven?" I asked. Then Maya asked, "Did you get chance? Have you got a chance to peek into the trunk?" Seven means, had you seen into the trunk? Nishad looked disappointed. He didn't even ask me in his set. Then he was very disappointed because Mr. Nath hadn't even told Seven to come inside. Means he hadn't offered Seven to come inside his room. Then he smiled. "But I did find out something, Maya. I went down to the restaurant where Ramesh works and talked to him." Then he smiled. Nishad was smiling and saying another experience that what he did. He said, "But I did find out something. He found out something. And what was that? He went down to restaurant and asked Ramesh about the meals and about Mr. Nath and about Mr. Nath's behavior." "Good for you, Mr. Detective," I said, patting him on the back. "I hope you questioned him properly." Then Maya was boosting her brother and she was patting him on the back and was saying, "Yes, good for you, Mr. Detective." Here, Mr. Detective means Nishad, her brother. And she was hoping that, yes, he had questioned properly to Ramesh. Seven looked pleased. Now, Seven was very happy. "Ramesh told me that he takes 2 meals for Mr. Nath every morning and evening and 2 cups of tea, one in the morning and one in the afternoon. Ramesh says he is not very particular about what he eats. It's always the same food, 2 chapatis, some dal and vegetables. Mr. Nath pays cash and tips well." So, dear students, what Ramesh told him, that there was, like, Mr. Nath always had the same food, 2 meals in the day. every morning and every evening. 2 meals were there and the same food, 2 cups of tea, 1 in the morning and 1 in the afternoon. Ramesh said him that he was not very particular. Who? Mr. Nath was not very particular about what he ate. It's always the same food. Always used to eat same food, 2 chapatis, some dal and vegetable. And always Mr. Nath pays cash. Okay, never keep due or never borrow the food. He just pays cash and tips well. Okay, so look at the chapter. Pramesh told me something very strange, Maya, 7 added. Dear student, now I am reading on the page number 88. Okay, so open the page number 88. At the top of the page, you will get the para and listen carefully. Ramesh told me something very strange, Maya, 7 added. Almost every Sunday, he carries 2 lunches to Mr. Nath's room and the same man is with him each time. He is tall, fair, stout and wears spectacles. Ramesh says his visitor talks a lot, unlike Mr. Nath, who hardly speaks. And he added, now Nishad had added what Ramesh told him, and Ramesh told him something very strange, very weird things about Mr. Nath. And he told, like, almost every Sunday Ramesh carried 2 lunch to Mr. Nath's room, and the same person always used to visit on Sunday to Mr. Nath. Okay, and the and how was the appearance of the stranger? The appearance is, he was tall, fair, stout, fat person and always used to wear spectacles. And Ramesh said his visitor talks a lot, means his visitor, the stranger who always used to come to Mr. Nath's room, was very talkative person. But yes, Mr. Nath was not, he always speaks hardly. Well done, Nishad, I told him. Now that we have made some progress with our inquiries, we will have to sort out all the facts like expert detectives so that we can trap the crook. Now, but Maya was saying, Maya told Nishad, well done, you have done a good job now. But we have done some progress also. We have found many things about Mr. Nath, but still many things are pending. We will have to sort out all the facts like expert detectives so that we can trap the crook, so that they can just trap, they can catch the crook, the criminal. How you do go on, Maya, 7 side. How can you possibly imagine he is a crook? He looks so ordinary. As Maya was thinking, the person was a crook. But Nishad's opinion was completely opposite. He was not thinking and he was not imagining him as a crook and criminal. And 7 said, how can you possibly imagine he is a crook? Means how Maya could possibly imagine like he was a crook. He looked so ordinary. The appearance and overall look of the person was very ordinary. So how could she say that? Then criminals can look quite ordinary, Smarty, I retorted. Okay, on the same page I am reading. Did you see the picture of the Hyderabadi housebreaker in the papers yesterday? He looks like any man on the street. Nishad looked doubtful. Now, criminal can look quite ordinary, Smarty, I retorted. Retorted means replied. In the same way as he questioned him. Then Maya said, had he seen the picture of the Hyderabadi housebreaker in the paper the last day? There was a picture of a criminal in the newspaper, and he looked like any man on the street, very ordinary man who was looking, but still he had robbed the house. So Nishad was very doubtful about these things. The monsoon broke the next day. Dark clouds accompanied by blinding flashes of lightning and roaring rolls of thunder burst with all their fury, flooding the street with a heavy downpour. School was to have reopened after the summer holidays, but no traffic could move through the flooded roads and there was an unexpected holiday. So what happened? Monsoon arrived. Okay, so the monsoon broke the next day. On the very next day, the monsoon arrived there, and yes, dark clouds and lightning and roaring rolls of thunder, and yes, very heavy rain. Okay, and heavy rain converted into flood, and because of the flood, the streets were blocked, and yes,
the school can't reopen because of the traffic. Nobody could move on the road. So unexpected holiday they got because of the flood. And yes, I thought I would spend the time usefully as it was unexpected holiday. So Maya was thinking that she is going to use all the moment of this day. And I sat at my desk in our bedroom with a sheet of paper before me. So she wanted to use the every minute of the day. So she sat on the study table, on the chair, on the desk in their bedroom and kept a sheet of paper before her. So that's all for today. So stay tuned for the next part of the lesson. Thank you.